Hi friends, myself Ram Kumar. Today we are going to discuss about the Blue Prism tool. I will make you walk through the complete step-by-step procedure of RPA implementation using Blue Prism tool, and then we will see how we can automate any business process with cost-effective and time-effective perspective. Okay, let's get a quick start. So the modules which we'll be covering is the Blue Prism tool overview, followed by the process studio where the processes are being configured, and object studio where every application is treated as an object and then how it is mapped into the respective object studio, and then error management or the exception handling means if a process or object or there is a exception while running a process and how we handle it and how effectively we can manage the process, we will see in this error management. Case management is a place where we work with queues, reporting systems and all other queue related things will be discussed here. This is the effective module here in Blue Prism, which is not available in any other RPA tools. And then we will see about something about surface automation, which is predominantly used to automate Citrix and remote desktop applications. Okay, and then we will see some additional features like logging and then environment variables and reporting stuff available within this Blue Prism, and then how we can effectively how it enhances the user in implementing the RPA. And then we will also see some best practices which can be spread across, widely used, so that you will follow it and then you will get the maximum benefit out of it. Okay, yeah. So let's get started with the overview. So in this overview we will talk about what are the components of Blue Prism, right? How the Blue Prism is structured, what is the Blue Prism architecture, right? And those also will be discussed in the components of Blue Prism. And then we will be talking about features of Blue Prism, means what all it is supporting, what all features it is having, right? We will be discussing in this module. And I will show you how the tool looks like, means once you log into the application or the software, how it looks like, what are the tabs available, what are the stages available, how we can drag and drop, what is the work area, where we can work on the tool, something like that, right? We'll see a live thing. And then mainly prerequisites, means for installing the Blue Prism software, what all we need, or to work on a Blue Prism tool, what all we need, and minimum required things so that your software will be working fine for you, right? So let's start with these components. So as we say, we can automate a business process with Blue Prism tool. For example, we see that there are three applications on the left, right? Think that one is based out of a desktop application, something like SAP or calculator, any Outlook, something is like that, okay? And then middle one is like something like mainframe application, and application one is something like a web application. So these are the applications which a process is, to get the process done, we need to interact with these three applications. This is the current manual process which they are doing. So what happens is, in Blue Prism, the software robot which we say consists of mainly two things. One is process studio, other is object studio. So object studio is the interface for us or for the process to interact with the application. Okay, means example, a process studio has a series of steps. Example, you need to go to application 1, read some data, and then you need to go to application 2, read some data, you need to go to application 3, and then you have to paste some data. This is the series of steps in a process. So that is configured in process studio, right? The series is a graphical representation of the steps which needs to be conducted, executed, and then which completes a process and we get a end product. So for this, so the process studio or the actions or the stages in process studio will be interacting with the object studio, which is like an interface of the application which we are communicating, Okay, so think that each application will be mapped to one business object, means a web application will be mapped to a business object one, and then a mainframe application is mapped to business object two, and then any desktop application like Excel sheet, Outlook, anything are mapped to business object three. So a software robot is consisting of one process and one or more business object studios actually, or business objects which we say. So object studio is the place where we develop the business objects. Process studio is the place where we develop the process. So what is application modular? So application modular will stand in between the applications and the object, which object is the interface of an application which we are saying, right? So what this application modular is doing is, application modular will store all the attributes of the application in it, so by which the object, business object, will be able to interact with the application. Think an example of web browser. Web browser, when you are saying, it will be a HTML. So HTML will have attributes like button, input box, text area, right, headers, something like that, right? So in that, drop downs, something like that, right? So all these kind of things, the attributes are, those details are stored in this application modular. So whereas these details are stored in application modular, when the object is thinking of interacting with the application to read or write or do such kind of operations, it will interact with the application through this application modular. Means it will connect to the application using the application modular, because application modular is the place where the details are stored in. Means application modular will have the example, the address details of the application, means where the input box is, where the drop down is, what is its name, what are its HTML path, what is the HTML ID. So example, all the details will be stored in application modular, so which will be used by the application studio. So the business object and the process together will become a software robot. So Blue Prism components is some extra we have is Blue Prism database. So all the information about what is the process, what is the sequence, what is the object, what are the actions available inside an object, what are the application modular details, everything will be stored in a database. So nothing will be stored inside the software robot or something like that. It's a working thing only. It will not store any values. You have to understand this, right? And then on top of this database, we have control room and system manager. Control room is nothing but where your process can be monitored, your queues can be monitored, your process can be scheduled, and then you can see the session variables. So the complete control management is done from control room. And then we have something called system manager. System manager is where we have this rules, who are the users of this tool, like administrator, developer, and then we will see how the logs are there for reporting. So all system related information like environmental variables, important user ID credentials, password encryptions, everything will be stored in system manager. So these are the high level of components which we have in Blue Prism. And then once we see the tool, and then once we get started with each feature, and when we get started with each stage of Blue Prism, you will get to know about the components in detail. Okay, so features. So when we talk about features, Blue Prism is having a set of libraries, tools and environments which will support the RPA concepts. Like if you take about, so we have something called security mechanism, right? When we say security mechanism, like, so we have role based access for each user, okay, and then it also makes you has credential encryption, user credential encryption, and then we have deployable on premise or cloud. Means this software can be deployed in a cloud based mechanism, where it will be like client server based. We can be operating on client server based mechanism, and then it can be in house as well, right? And then we have something called work queues, where each the items or the records or the data which needs to be processed can be loaded into this work queues, and then Work use will make sure the load is spread across all the boards, software boards, and then we are able to process each and every item, and then we can track the status of the process as well, whether the item is being done or not. So this work queue is very important critical feature of Blue Prism, which takes it to higher levels, and then it makes it lead the RPA implementers. Okay, control room, as we are discussing, right, it can be, if it is able to control, monitor and schedule the number of runtime resources, means which process to run on which board and for how much time, how many times repetition. So all this can be controlled from a control room. Release manager. When we talk about release manager, so not only like each it is one time doing, we can have a version of the things which we are doing. Example, we have a process on phase one where it does a steps of 1, 2, 3, right? Now we can have an enhanced version of process where the fourth step is added to it. So this release manager is used to handle or make a copy of process along with the one or more business object mapped to it. So we can store them in some places, and then accordingly we can deploy or import into the Blue Prism tool, and the process can be executed from anywhere, right? Dependency tracking, we can see what are the applications which are monitored or which are interacted, and then how the data is getting transferred. Reporting and analytics, where if you want to see what is the software robot doing, what time the process started, for each step what is the time taken. So there are this kind of metrics available within the Blue Prism itself, which will make you to understand the overall performance of the tool. So Process Studio, as we discussed earlier, Process Studio is a place where we configure the process step by step in a graphical way. It's not just a two dimensional graph, it's a working computer program. You will see how which step the current status is in, and then how the control is moving from in what direction it is moving, something like that, right? Object Studio. So here you will configure or you will make sure what are the actions available in the application. Example, in an application like web browser, you have actions like clicking, submitting a form, or if you take an Excel application like reading or writing, these all are actions, right, which we perform on any application. So those all actions are configured in the Objects Studio, which is like again in a graphical format only. Application modular, as we discussed, it will store the attributes of the application, and then it is the place where this is the channel through which we can interact with the actual application. It's always OOPS concept, means every application or everything is based out of object oriented programming structure. So everything is done in that way. Okay, and then this is built on .NET framework. So any features can be added, like we have some features now, and then if think that you Excel sheet is having some 100 features, so currently 90 features are being implemented, and then it is ready for use in Blue Prism tool. You are looking for a feature which is not available, so something can be developed in .NET C# code, and then it can easily plugged into this kind of Blue Prism tool. So mainly it is technology agnostic, means it is not specific or limited for usage for a specific technology. So when we say it's not limited for only desktop applications, not only for web applications, not only for remote desktop applications. So it is technology agnostic, where it is not limited to any tool, and then it is able to interact with web services, thin and thick clients, Citrix applications, right, SAP, any Java application, Windows applications, mainframe applications, XMLs, Excel sheet, Outlook, so something like this. So there is no limitation. We can interact with any application you want to do with as a human is doing, right? So that is the beauty here, and then we will see in step by step how it is there. So next is tool look and feel. Let me just quickly show you how a Blue Prism tool looks like. Okay, so just I am here, my database is already configured, and then let me sign it. So this is the login screen of the Blue Prism tool. So once you log in, you will be on the home screen. Okay, so this is just a dashboard of what are the processor ready, how many are available, means what are, how are the boards available. There's some dashboards is showing something, as of now it will be not useful for you. When you are using your bot for executing any process, you will see the difference here and you will understand the use of it here. So the important thing is the studio. So studio has two things, one is process studio and object studio, right? So as I told you, so process studio will contain all the processes are configured here, and then object studio will have all the objects configured here. We will go through one by step when we are actually discussing about each module or each studio in detail in my next series of videos, but here this is just get a glimpse of how a tool looks like. So the control board or control room we are talking about, right? This is the dashboard where it has the control room details, like we can see what are the sessions available, right? What are the sessions available, and then what are the queues available. So here I did not configure anything, because while we are doing it, we'll get to know how to change a queue name, how to add items to a queue, and how to schedule a queue, how to make the items in a queue visible for the bots or to process it, and then what are the schedules available, so what are the activities, what are the reports. So everything will be managed from queue here. So just see how the tool is looking like from control dashboard and then control room, and then we will go forward like this. So dashboard, as I said, this is of no use as of now. Once you have some process objects and then many things in place and you are doing some executions, business process executions, you will get the relevant data onto the dashboard so that you can get a clear view of how the robot is performing. So releases, I was telling you, right, this is something like we have some, so we have some data available, process and some objects are available, and then we are packaged it into something called a release. So every enhancements we do it, we will make it a release, and then the versioning control is there in this releases. Okay, so once we have a major release, minor release, everything will be packaged here and then can be exported as a file, so which can be imported into any other Blue Prism tool, right? So lastly, we have something called system, as I was telling, right, this have the details of what are the process available, what are the environment variables available, and then what are the types, what are the web services which we are consuming, what are the web services which we are exposing, how many resources are there, means what is the, how, what are the resources which are available, means how many virtual machines are available which can ready, which are ready to take up the task. So who are the users available, so what are the credentials in this thing, and then what are the encryption schemas which we are following. So many things are there, right? And then auditing, like it will completely give the details of what are the process logs captured, what are the object logs captured, what is the audit logs captured, and then what is the design. So system will have something like what are the settings, and then you can import the license here, and many other such kind of things. So we'll go to this one by one in our videos, but here these are the main components which a Blue Prism tool will be having, right? So coming back, so after this we have something called prerequisites. Prerequisites means for a Blue Prism tool to run, what all we should have. So first thing is we have to have a SQL server. So SQL Express 2012 and above are preferred, wherein it is connected to this database and all the information is stored into this SQL server. And then the details into the SQL server which are stored all can be packaged and then be exported as a BP release file which can be imported anywhere, right? And then followed by, we need to have the Blue Prism software installation file which can be easily installed on any desktop machine or a laptop or anything, and then we can start using it. Before that, we need to have a license where once the software is installed there, we need to have the license which can be keyed in, and then every license will have an 1 year of expiry, and then we have some training license, we have enterprise license, that depends on the nature of use you do it, okay? And then definitely on your machine you need to have the .NET framework, as the tool is built on top of .NET, so you need to have the .NET framework ready on your machine so that the tool will start working. So hope so we have seen the overview of the Blue Prism tool. So we will get started into the next modules of process theory and series of steps actually, and then you will be seeing them in the next videos. Thank you for watching. Keep learning.